is Christmas. And what have you done? Merry Christmas, everyone! My name is Tony Baloney, and this is the Ontario Indie Holiday Special. And it's gonna be special. I can tell.
T'was the night before Christmas, and all through the venue, not a fan was in sight, or a This Is Awesome chant in the air. But in the distance, jingle bells ring. Oh wait, those aren't jingle bells. That's a ring bell.
They're open and fastened in the presents bag,
in which all presents under the tree are free to be used against your opponent. Introducing first, hailing from downtown Toronto, the Wild Child, Jody
present match.
Fans of Go Hard Pro, this is Adam B. with Dr. Bob as we're about to get ready for a holiday festive matchup between Jody Threat and Von Vertigo.
And these two look like kids on Christmas morning tearing away at their Christmas presents. What are they going to get here? I think I can already guess Jody's.
Oh, it's a skateboard. What a shock. What a swizzer.
The perfect present. And what's Von Vertigo going to get in this special stipulation? All presents, all gifts under the tree are a legal matchup.
You're screwed, buddy.
Going in it, Dr. Bob, it's the champion!
Chris Jericho action figure? This is just what I wanted.
Chris Jericho here. Don't tell us Go Hard Pro doesn't bring the best from all across the world. I think we just blew our budget with that one.
Jody Threat now placing Jericho in the inner circle of that skateboard.
Aw, this is so cute, playing so well.
You're
nope,
doing it wrong!
Come on, Dad. About to say, they're playing so well together, but, this one's got to turn into a match eventually, right, Adam?
Well, the holidays do bring out the worst of people. Dr. Bob, a very aggressive time of year is the holiday season, as Von Vertigo now showing off his skateboard skills to Jody Threat.
Oh, being a little bit of a Grinch here, that's not the holiday spirit.
Whoa!
Oh!
You know, anyway,
And off to a rocket start, a punch straight to the face. That's usually how my holidays end up, I guess.
Oh, God.
Both Jody Threat and Von Vertigo, well-traveled competitors. Von Vertigo, several tours of the UK. Jody Threat, multiple appearances in the United States.
Places like Black Label Pro, GCW, all around some of the biggest companies across the U.S. And that might be a little bit under the skin of Von Vertigo, who has years, over a decade over Jody Threat in terms of experience. These two very, very evenly matched, I think.
No, fought quite often
in tag team matches and multi-person matches. They know each other quite well.
Gets planted with the Michinoku. Driver does Vertigo. I've seen Jody. No. Way too early for that, Dr. Bob. I've seen Jody Threat compete in one-on-one matches on several occasions. Very rare opportunity for me to see Von Vertigo in a straight-up singles matchup.
Well, these two are going to have a very different strategy, I'd say. Jody Threat can have to come with her explosive and with her power, maybe with her weapons here, too. Vertigo's going to have to use his experience and his speed.
Crazy.
Well, speaking of that... Jody Threat goes right
hard house.
Right into the bleachers goes Threat.
Just like that, Von Vertigo is in the driver's seat, the skateboarding driver's seat. I don't know. I don't skateboard. Oh,
still has the support of Jericho. Quotation marks. I'm doing bunny ears when I see Jericho. Just to make sure.
Super there, are we? Ow! Almost got the pin.
Oh, cracks her with the action figure. Dr. Bob, I've seen it all in my many years of calling matches, but I've never seen anybody use an action figure. No, wait, I think there was one time, so it's been a long time since I've seen an action figure be used in a wrestling match.
Sure you call a few sexy Eddie matches. Anyways, back here. Vertigo. Picking up for his own Michinoku drive, perhaps. Oh no, just a scoop slap hard onto another figure.
That's a different kind of action, brother. But nonetheless, Von Vertigo now in control of this matchup. Taking his time.
Oh, those chocolate and Lindor. Don't spoil those.
Hey, come on now.
Hey, as two fat kids over here, we'd be very upset if chocolate gets spilled.
It's been a long quarantine, Dr. Bob.
Yeah. I've been packing on the quarantine pounds. Von Vertigo picks up Jody Threat. Some wicked forearms. Although I wouldn't
Jody Threat gonna have the power advantage over Von Vertigo. Vertigo tried bringing in the strikes. Threat dropped him. Oh my God! Hooks the leg, only gets two.
It went vertical right into her spine.
Vertigo trying for the...
I thought it was going to be a lot of fun and games earlier in the matchup. You know, nice little stipulation, but this is turning into a hellacious holiday for Jody Threat.
Well, Von Vertigo has shown off in the past a very vicious side. Has been known to have fun, been known to dance to Electric Six, but all business here against Jody Threat.
Well, he's got Chris Jericho watching him on.
Where'd it go?
I'm still selling that. Okay. Threat trying to get back into this matchup as again Von Vertigo going for the skateboard.
But I mean, insult to injury here too. The skateboard so synonymous with Jody Threat. Using it against her. Just missed what would have been the end of that match.
Threat moves in, hooks Vertigo. Vertigo right back.
A little bit low. Come here. The V guy does not make that suplex, being reversed again by the powerhouse that is Jody Threat.
Very underrated power wrestler is Jody Threat. Vertigo learning that the hard way.
Wild Child's got a lot and will not be tamed by Von Vertigo here. What other weapons are they going to find? What other gifts under the tree?
Both wrestlers struggling to get back up. Get the advantage back up into this matchup as Jody grabs Vertigo.
More forearms are working well for her this match.
Vertigo holds on, gets the boot up into the face. Has the action figure again. Oh, my!
Oh, no. Called on a little bit of a cheap shot, but all weapons here are legal. All gifts are legal. What else are they going to unwrap?
Vertigo might be going to the well once too often, or the walls once too often.
Oh! On his face.
Acai, nothing there.
Get up!
Threat sizing him up. Went for that spear.
Just finished a lot of her opponents with that one. Vertigo showing that experience factor. He knows his opponent very, very well.
This is in the corner. Threat grabs a hold of him. Little low on the kick, but effective from Jody.
That's Vertigo position. Knees to the back yet again.
German suplex plants Vertigo. A little slow to follow up the cover. Only gets two.
I've seen her finish off opponents with that spear, with that German suplex. Also with her repetitive F5. She's got a lot of really big moves in her arsenal that can finish a matchup just like that. One thing that Vaughn's got to watch out for. Oh! Going for that F5!
Vertigo struggling to break free, able to get to the ropes.
Holding on. Another
referee
guess.
With the count.
Might be going Dr. Terry Funk, Ric Flair on this one. Oh.
Oh my God, you're right. Brings down Threat with the assist from the bang. Good callback there, Dr. Bob. Shining Wizard. No, only gets two.
Not enough. I thought that was it. Even the ref looks a little incredulous here. Vertigo's got to stay on her, and I think that's one of the weak points he has in his game. He gets upset. He lets his emotions take over him way too soon. But this is his match to lose right now.
And like I mentioned before, Dr. Bob, no tag team partner to tag out to blow off some of that steam. Get back into his winning mindset, and now Jody Threat planted over the skateboard.
What a match this has been here. What an entire event Gohar Pro has been.
Hey, I'm happy to be a part of it. Get to do this with you one more time. It's been too long, brother.
What a happy holiday.
Misses. No water in the pool.
The third time.
Oh, but no, the knee. It caught the skateboard. Big clothesline from Jody Threat. Smartly pulled up that skateboard.
One too many times.
One, two.
Only gets two. Could Jody Threat be waiting to go for the 180 ollie for the 1-2-3? No, Vertigo fights her off again.
Vicious elbows.
But no, Threat holds on once again using the power. Using that fire, plants him. Here comes the pain onto that skateboard. Side sealed and delivered for Jody Threat. I bet you missed that one, Dr. Bob.
Happy holidays, folks.
Thank you so much, Go Hard Pro, for including us into this event. It's an absolute pleasure, absolute treat. Fans, hope to see you guys soon.
Merry Christmas! No, you break your key!
No!
What? No! It's
the worst Christmas ever!
Merry Christmas!
You know what I hate?
What?
Christmas.
That's unfortunate.
You wanna know why?
Go ahead.
Go ahead. Ask me what I got for Christmas last year.
What'd you get for Christmas last year?
An onion.
Do you like onions?
No, I don't like onions. And I know what you're thinking. It's the thought that counts. Yeah, I'm a grown boy. I could grill up an onion and make a meal out of it. But look at me. It's bulking season. The most I can get out of an onion is like two meals at the most. And sure, maybe you're saying it's the thought that counts.
Uh-huh.
Well, maybe people should have better thoughts. I can't have all the good thoughts for everybody. It's not fair to me. Uh-huh. Why can't everybody else think of something good, huh? And you know what it is? You know what it is? It's not just was born hating Christmas. That's not how it happened. It's all the commercialism, right? And you know what? With all this COVID stuff, yeah, oh yeah, sure, let's cancel Halloween. Oh, Halloween, that's like a B holiday. I don't think so. If Halloween's canceled, Christmas is canceled.
I just haven't been the same since those stupid Whovillians kicked me out of their stupid town. This is not fair.
What, just because I like the color green and I look different?
You know what? This world has enough Who Villains. They need a Who Villain. And I'm gonna give it to them.
I know, it's not easy being nice to the grumpy person. The grumpy person is not really interested in nearly anything. I'm done with that. But I deserve love too. Stupid Christmas. Just forcing everybody to be happy. What if I want to be miserable? What if I just don't want to be happy, huh? And these gifts. Don't get me started on those stupid gifts. Oh, it's Christmas. I'm going to pretend to like you for once a year. Oh. Stupid Santa Claus. Did you know Santa Claus isn't even real? He was invented by Coca-Cola. And I love Coca-Cola just as much as the next guy. But that has nothing to do with Christmas. You know what? I got an idea. Put this on. Come with me.
Once again.
A super shower washing every body part with Astral soap, including all my major crevices, including.
That's good.
Hey! If any of you are looking for any last-minute gift ideas for me, I have one. I like Frank Shirley, my boss, right here. Tonight.
The following contest is a Frank Shirley Your Opponent match, in which the winner of this bout will be the first competitor to deliver a monologue! Introducing first, from Hamilton, Ontario, with 225!
Yo!
You cheap lying, no good victim!
Into a wrestling gym.
There's scrap.
Oh, I think I passed it.
Scrap what?
Scrap metal. There's a wrestling ring there. We can take it, sell it. It's gonna be a merry ho-ho.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah.
How do we know no one's there?
I heard through the grapevine that the owner is out of town and he's got some little 12-year-old looking kid looking after the gym for him. So,
12 years old?
Yeah, 12 years old. And, hey, I don't know about you, but I can handle 12-year-olds.
12-year-olds are scared of the dark.
You're afraid of the dark.
I'm not scared of the dark anymore. You know that.
You're still scared of the dark.
Steve, I'm a 52-year-old man. I told you not to bring that up. Five night lights when I was growing up!
Five night lights!
Steven! Look out!
That's the kid.
That's the kid.
Yeah, this is the place.
That's the place?
This is the place. That's the kid.
That little girl is watching the wrestling gym?
I guess she's very responsible. I don't know.
This is a piece of cake.
This is the place. This is the place. That was the kid. I'm telling you, that was the kid.
This place.
Look at this scrap on the door. We can take that too.
Where we go right now?
No. I think take off, get a bite to eat, come back, I say, 9 o'clock.
When it gets dark.
Yep, when it gets dark. And it gives us enough time to stop for your nightlight.
Shut up.
Next time they come back, I'll be ready.
Revolution fans, it's Amy Crimson here, and I'm wishing you a Merry Christmas.
Hi, this is Leah Vaughn from Revolution's Women's Wrestling, and I want to wish you a happy and safe holiday from my family to yours.
Happy holidays from Revolution Women's Wrestling.
What's up, everybody? It's your elite athlete, Nova, wishing you all a happy holidays. Stay healthy and stay safe.
Hey guys, it's Crystal Moon here, wishing you a happy holidays from Revolution Women's Wrestling. Stay safe.
This is Shiloh with Revolution Women's Wrestling, and this is Spaghetti. And together, we would love to wish you and yours a happy holiday season. We can't wait to see everyone in 2021.
Hi, this is Madison Miles from Revolution Pro Wrestling. I just want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and happy holidays.
Divya here with Revolution Women's Wrestling to wish you and your family very happy holidays and a very Merry Christmas.
Why, hello there, it's me, Bianca Corelli from Revolution Women's Wrestling, live in the forest, just to wish you a Merry Christmas and a very, very happy holiday season.
The following match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from the Great White North, weighing 210 pounds, Shane Saber. Yeah! The Godfather's in the house. Christmas. And an early
Wow, what a matchup that we've got here. When you want to talk about an all-star combination, Alessandro Del Bruno, the Godfather, taking on Shane Saber, who over the past couple of years has been one of the fastest rising stars in Canadian pro wrestling. A bit of a shake of the hand, perhaps. A little holiday shake. Del Bruno not going for it. He and Saber going to square off. The amount of championship gold between these two guys is unbelievable. Del Bruno in Alpha One Wrestling, which I know fairly well. A Grand Slam champion. Shane Saber, multiple time tag team champion. And of course, not too long ago, he had an incredible matchup with Davey Boy Smith Jr. that really showed his mat wrestling ability. And he's going to need that here as Del Bruno locks him over. Modified Indian Deathlock. Saber, nice pull of the heel to reverse. Tries to capture the foot of Del Bruno. And he'll slide away. With Alessandro Del Bruno, you got to watch those educated feet. One from Milan, the other from Juventus. I know he'll appreciate that one anyway. Drop down from Del Bruno, rolls away. Nice wrist lock over the top. Pins it down to the mat. Look at the torque he's got on the wrist. Back into the mat, torquing the elbow. Saber will roll out of it. Takes control of the wrist of Del Bruno. Arm wringer into a wrist lock. Nicely done. And the pressure from Saber working him through. Roll through from Del Bruno. Hip up back to his feet. And now the series. Watch him go. Del Bruno, backflip out of it. And rolls right back through. Saber, nice single leg trip.
Come on, ref!
Stepped outside and tossed him, and I don't think the Godfather was too appreciative of that one. Referee Brad Myers, and what a job he does. So let's get it back going. Collar and elbow tie-up. Side headlock from Shane Saber. And when you wanted a holiday matchup, this is a Christmas present for any wrestling fan right here with these two. Del Bruno fires off with a block from Saber. Cover. Oh, look at the slide out from Del Bruno and the standing moonsault to the back. Count of one. That's all he'll get. Saber out quickly. But oh, the athleticism of Alessandro Del Bruno. He's had it from the first time I ever saw him. I've had the pleasure of calling many, many a Del Bruno match. As he lays in the knife edge chop, off the ropes, under tackle from Shane Saber. Del Bruno kicks away, up and over the top goes Saber. Leapfrog from Del Bruno, pushed back to the rope. Saber ducks down, cartwheel out of the way from Del Bruno. Go behind, waist lock, Saber swings, misses. Del Bruno pushes him to the ropes, Del Bruno ducked too early. Saber popped him up, but Del Bruno didn't let himself get caught for long. Flipped him over with that Hurricane Rana. Out to the apron goes Del Bruno. Oh, that shotgun-like apron kick. Del Bruno standing on the apron.
You're done, Saber.
Moonsault to the floor, caught. Saber hoists him. Oh, tornado DDT almost into a modified face buster. Into that apron of the ring. I mean, that is where wood meets steel.
Keep it in the ring. What?
That was innovative from Del Bruno.
Two.
He didn't go all the way through with a DDT and fall to his own back. He just kind of guided Saber into it.
Yeah.
Del Bruno, wheelbarrow. Trying to slide his way through. Saber from behind, rolled him up schoolboy style. Del Bruno got out of that. Saber takes the arm. Looking to scissor it. Oh, now look at this. Saber gets a hold of that wrist. And now rolls through. Now look at the way Saber's torquing this. He's got his legs separating the arm, scissoring the arm of Del Bruno, essentially isolating it, and then using his own clasp grip to pull on the elbow. Oh, that is pulling your arm in a way that nature did not intend. Del Bruno, very resilient. Oh, forearm shot to the jawline. Saber charges him, pops him into the corner. Shoulder block, make it three, four, as Saber fires him in.
Back to the center.
Of course, you can never count on Del Bruno. Talked about Saber's accomplishments earlier in the incredible match that he had with Davey Boy Smith Jr. Del Bruno has gone up against and defeated a who's who in professional wrestling.
Saber, you back it up. You keep it in the center.
As Saber fires in those lariats in the corner. Knife edge chop, and that drops Del Bruno. Count of one, two, and out the back door he goes. Del Bruno has main evented against some of the best in the world. Guys like All Ego Ethan Page, the walking weapon Josh Alexander. Up to the shoulders goes Saber. Harvey goes Del Bruno. He gets down, push Saber into the ropes. Del Bruno flips up. Caught him downstairs with a kick. Pops him up. Del Bruno up and over the top. Saber read it coming. Del Bruno able to get out the backside. Big neck breaker. He nailed him. Count of two. And that's all he'll get. Again, the athleticism of Alessandro Del Bruno coming into play out the back door, and then he climbed the ladder to be able to get that leaping neck breaker. And with the distance and the velocity of that coming down, Shane Saber is rocked. Back to the corner. Saber pushes him off. Del Bruno says, forget that. I'm going to throw the boots.
Hey, watch the hair. One.
Saber down in the corner.
Two. Out of the corner, back.
Oh, Del Bruno gets him up only to kick him right to the midsection. Del Bruno charges. Lariat lands. Saber right down to the seat.
I think so.
Del Bruno taking his time, and that allowed Saber an opening to get the chop in. And another. Del Bruno to the midsection again, just drops Saber. Those kicks, the power on them that he can get in a short distance. Go behind, rear waist lock. Reversal from Saber. Off the ropes. Del Bruno drops, rolls back. Saber again caught him. Tilt-a-whirl power slam of sorts and a basement drop kick. Saber brings Del Bruno up to the shoulders. He's got him captured. Almost a kryptonite crunch, count of two, and that's a kick out there. Saber, instead of going Samoan drop, twisted Del Bruno down to the side. Well, I've seen him use that before as a neck breaker, but that time he brought him almost like going way back in the books, Nova's kryptonite crunch, holding the head to the side. Up and over the top goes Del Bruno. Moonsault, and that one was the Pele kick. And he leveled him with it. You see Saber slow to get to his feet. Handspring perhaps from Del Bruno. Saber tried to get him. Del Bruno again, unbelievable with the feet. Look at the dexterity and how he was able to reach back, kick down the hand.
Come on!
Oh, Saber says, bring it. That might be the wrong guy to tell to bring it. Oh, Del Bruno with those unbelievable kicks. Oh, Saber caught the leg.
No.
Backs him up. Del Bruno blocked. Open hand strike. It's like a palm striking now. Buonanotte, perhaps.
You're done. Buonanotte.
Yep, you got it. Trying to bring him up. Saber's got to fight his way out of it. Del Bruno still has the pump handle. Saber able to step through. Oh, big right forearm from Shane Saber. Del Bruno answers back with one of his own. Del Bruno again. Rocked by Saber. Saber rocked by Del Bruno. These two just back and forth. And now Saber reining in with the rights. Hammering over the top. He's landing those right at the point of the jaw. And there's those feet again from Del Bruno. Just as Saber thought he was in complete control, out of nowhere, the kick comes up from Del Bruno. You gotta watch those feet every moment you're in the ring with Del Bruno. Now they're nose to nose. Saber caught him. Oh, that bullet DDT! Spear! 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 Saber! Count it two! No! And a kick up from Del Bruno!
Two! Only two! Shoulder was up! Only two! Two!
Oh, only two! How in the world did Del Bruno get out of that? That short arm, that ripcord DDT, which set up the spear. How many people have we seen put that away before from Shane Saber? Del Bruno pulling himself up in the corner. You knew this was going to be a war. But my goodness gracious, I can't believe the back and forth here. I thought Saber had him. Right forearm to the jawline. Back Saber up. Oh, did you hear the sound of that one? Saber pops Del Bruno up to his shoulders. To the middle of the ring. What's he got in mind here? Del Bruno trying to slide out of it. Almost looked like Saber going for one winged angel. Del Bruno able to spiral down wheelbarrow cutter. How did he do that? How did he turn his body to be able to make that happen? Two. Count him two and it's still not over.
Only two, shoulder was up, only two. Come on, only two, Del Bruno.
What do these two have to do? Saber's gotta be out of it. Saber thought he had him. To the middle of the ring, it really looked like Shane Saber was going to attempt one winged angel. And instead, Del Bruno tornadoes himself out of it, lands perfectly to set up his wheelbarrow cutter.
Five.
Count is up to five on both men.
Six.
Now to six, and Del Bruno pops back to his feet. He has so much in the tank. You just can't gas Alessandro Del Bruno. Saber able to get out of the way initially. Up and oh, pop up powerbomb. Count of one, two, get eight. No, he just couldn't get the feet over the shoulders of Alessandro Del Bruno. It gave him just a slight exit and he was able to take it. He hit that pop up powerbomb with all kinds of power to it. I mean, the velocity coming down, you saw the way Del Bruno went into the air and all one motion from Shane Saber, pop him up and pull him down. Now sitting Del Bruno on that top rope, what's Shane Saber got in mind here? Samoan drop from the top rope, no. Del Bruno counters, pulls that head down. Oh, there's that punt. Straight up the middle. And that'll rock Saber in the corner. Del Bruno charges, boots him to the face. Now sitting Saber to the top rope.
You're dead.
Saber down over the top. Del Bruno pulls him through. Bonanotte, count one, two. No! He doesn't have him. Shane Saber just kicked out of Bonanotte. Did you see how Alessandro Del Bruno did that? He pulled Shane Saber off the top rope with the arm trapped. Pump handle, Bonanotte. All one motion.
Good riddance, Saber.
I mean, there is no wasted motion at all in this match.
Yep.
Saber down. Here comes the punt. He was looking for that golden goal.
Hold on a second.
And now he's caught. Saber has the boot. Up and over the top. Del Bruno twists out of it. Saber charges. How did Del Bruno get that kick off? Spins him to the ropes. And Saber turns him inside out. Saber again. With him up. Del Bruno lands on his feet. Spinning back kick lands. Del Bruno falls into the cover. This has got to be all. Saber out the backside. Sweeps him over. And he got him. Shane Saber. Are you kidding me?
Shane Saber.
Saber looked done. The spinning back kick. Del Bruno fell into the cover. Saber crucifix him. Rolls him over, and Shane Saber picks up the victory. Well, it's going to be a Merry Christmas in the Great White North. Shane Saber gets the win over Alessandro Del Bruno. What a match. It doesn't even matter. And there you see Victoria Shane Sabre. Boy, he knows he was in an absolute battle in this one. Alessandro Del Burro gave him everything and then some. And Shane Sabre, in the end, uses the brain to win.
One more time, please.
I said we're gonna ruin someone's Christmas.
Okay. Whose?
I don't know. I don't know who lives here, but look at this. This is a bougie ass house. You know they got good decorations. What are you doing? Put your mask on. Here's your brain.
Hey everybody, it's Sean and Amanda Gibson here for Barry Wrestling.
We are really missing all of the wrestling fans and all the wrestlers. We can't wait to see you guys again soon. And we just hope that you're all keeping healthy and safe during these crazy times. And we just want to wish a Merry Christmas to your family from us and all of our many kids.
And hopefully we got this year okay and out of lockdowns and out of COVID. Because there's not much to do in COVID except maybe have more kids. That's awesome. It's something that could happen. It's a thing that you see that now, but locked
in. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, kids. It's your Uncle Kingdom here, Anthony Kingdom James. Just popping by Go Hard Pro Wrestling to wish everybody a Merry Christmas. Hold on. Let's make it more Christmas-like. How's that? Is that more Christmas-like? I know this Christmas is going to be different for a lot of us. We're not going to get to see our friends and family just to be safe. So thank goodness for things like Go Hard Pro to keep us busy and keep us entertained. I know there's probably going to be a lot of Christmas movies watched this year, more than usual. And I want to make sure that you're watching the right movies. A lot of people argue about what's a Christmas movie, and I want to clarify a few things, okay? Right off the bat, Home Alone. Home Alone is not a great movie, but it's a Christmas movie. I mean, that can't be argued. It's all about Christmas. The kid's home alone because his family went somewhere for Christmas. It's a Christmas movie. On the other hand, something like Trading Places, part of it might take place at a Christmas party, but it's not a Christmas movie. And by that logic, Die Hard. Sorry. Die Hard is not a Christmas movie. I'm sorry to ruin that for you. National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. It is a Christmas movie, but it sucks so bad. It's horrible. One guy says, "Shitter's full," and everybody loves this movie. Remember that Randy Quaid is an awful human being in real life. Say no to National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. There's two others that I really want to talk about. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer is torture porn. This poor little weirdo is ostracized. They don't let him play any reindeer games. They treat him like he's got a disease. Until his mutant nose is capable of helping them. So unless you can contribute something to their little society, they give him the heave-ho. That's a terrible message to send to the kids. And by that measure, I love It's a Wonderful Life. It's one of the best movies ever. Whether it's Christmas or not, it's an amazing movie. But it's a horror movie. It's a Wonderful Life is about a guy who finds out from an angel that the only way his entire town can live happily is if none of his dreams are ever fulfilled. I mean, sure, he gets a hot wife and they have a big house and a family, but he never gets to travel outside of his city limits, and having kids sucks. And that's why I just want you to know that the one thing you should watch this Christmas, the best Christmas movie of all, isn't even really a movie. It's A Charlie Brown Christmas. A Charlie Brown Christmas is perfect in every way. Wait a minute. Get yourself a little tree and celebrate Christmas like your Uncle Kingdom's gonna do. Merry Christmas to Go Hard Pro, to everybody who participates in the show, and to everybody at home watching. Merry Christmas.
Oh, somebody lifts. Hold on.
Huh?
There's a kettlebell. Smart for that. Oh!
Baseball. Well, there's the bell, and I am your host, the Christmas Krampus, Clowny Jay, and we're going to see what's going on.
I believe you are
a little point off between pretty old Saint Rick himself and the real Kris Kringle.
Yeah, well, we'll just
look
see
at the
about
beard.
That.
It's real.
Let's see what's going on here as we find out who truly has the ho ho holiday spirit. And we're going to start things off with a Santa sumo off. Does not work the bell that St. Rick intends as he is dropped down, crawls to the corner. Really not showing the Christmas spirit there, just shoving off his opponent. But the rules of this match is you must strip the opposing Santa, which that's going to cause all sorts of deviant art right there. We're getting a North Pole knuckle lock, something very common around those parts.
Oh my god!
And look, it just drops St. Rick down and takes the gloves. That is not Christmassy.
Why would
it is
you
cold
do that
outside.
To me?
You gotta be wearing gloves.
Oh, God.
And now,
okay,
right in the belly full of jelly. Jesus. Fear or cheer, the Belchnickel is here with these shots. You don't treat Santa's helpers that way. Don't shove him. St. Rick getting set up back in the corner. Looks like he just wants a little tie-up. Go behind. Try to get his arms around that belly of Santa's. That one too many cookies this year.
Okay.
Santa with the reversal. Or sorry, the real St. Nick with the reversal. And then just... He just... Yeah, he took his pants. He just took the man's pants. Oh no, just his belt, thankfully. His pants are still on. I'm glad to report his pants are still on. But things are really not going the way that St. Rick would want. The real Kris Kringle still fully dressed. Little jab. Santa swinging wildly. Enziguri step up, bucks off the hat.
I got him.
Little freak Mr. Hat there on the ground. He's got a sack of toys. He's got some goodies. What's he got? He just jingled his bells with that shot. And just again with the shot. One for Dasher, one for Dancer. Put his Prancer in there. Choking him out for Vixen now.
You are so nice! Come on, quick!
Yeah, he's going to be seeing comics after this.
What are you doing? Right. You're this type of match? You're totally on the naughty list.
Lacing up those bells like they're in love. Perhaps Cupid's involved.
All right. You take it.
Going back over now. Tearing at the real Kris Kringle. Going for that belt, that jacket. He's getting it. He's getting it. The belt is off.
All right, it's off.
The belt is off. The Santa suit, he just sat up. Kris Kringle sat and took the jacket into his face.
Get it off me!
Big Santa scoop slam. Set right there in the middle. Kris Kringle misses that splash. Well, you know, Santas are known for their peaceful, loving ways. They're not known to partake in violence, especially with one of their own. Except for St. Rick here, who's got the idea with the belt buckle. He's been naughty. There it is again, perhaps a little too naughty this holiday season.
Put that away.
He's whipping Kris Kringle with a leather strap, I mean.
Oh, come on now, what happened, Chris?
I know everybody's into Mr. something, Kringle? Folks.
Come on,
what did
I say? Put that away.
Just choking him out. The real Kris Kringle would rather a lump of coal at this point.
Never touched him.
You see the Santa's helper out there admonishing St. Rick for the choke.
Put this guy away.
Of course, there is no disqualification in a Santa suit match.
A jackknife powerbomb!
He's calling a shot. He cannot lift him, though. And he is
up.
With a dasher-like flight. as the real Kris Kringle strips him of that belly full of jelly. St. Rick is rather svelte to be a Santa Claus. Christmas karate chop.
Santa chop.
And a sleigh ride splashed up following up. This may be one of the more bizarre things that I've ever called. What's he going? He's going for the stocking. That stocking was hung with joy. Oh no.
I still got my pants on.
Oh no. Mr. Stocko. Lifts him up with a slam, almost like a mandible slam. And then, there go the pants. I am not sleeping tonight.
Yes!
Here is your winner, Kris Kringle, the real Santa!
You better watch out, you better not cry.
You're on the naughty list. But you can have this stuff. Merry Christmas. Thank you. Happy holidays.
Checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming.
Happy holidays, kids. This is bogus! I'm not leaving! This is my Christmas! I bought the damn building! Give me the ring! Give me the title! I'm Santa Claus! I'm Santa Claus! This is my Christmas! Where's my present? Where's my present? This is my title! Oh god!
Look at this guy!
Double
come
the title!
Come on.
Where is it? Look at this.
Where is
the title? Huh?
Hey,
come on! Hey! Give me the
belt! Come on!
Give me the belt, I want it! I want it!
Christmas time! It's Christmas time!
Thank you! Thank you!
It's Christmas time!
Thank you! I won! I won! I totally won! I totally won! You knew it! You knew that I won!
Oh, wait!
Oh! 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 No! No! No!
Oh boy! Here
no!
You
no!
Hey! Happy holidays from the Ontario Performance Center.
Get him out of here.
Come on! Let's go! Let's go!
Oh, good God!
You okay, buddy?
I think I won.
Let's go.
I think I got
Let's
him.
Go.
I think I got him on that one. Which one was it?
You did come good. On.
I did
come
win.
On.
You did good.
You
I
did
win.
It's Christmas time.
I did win. Oh, happy Easter, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
from us to you. Stay safe and be good for Santa. He's a good boy for Santa. Thank you, Eddie.
I'm Lukewarm Frantic.
And I'm the Blue Mini Freak Show.
And we are Job Squad Radio.
And we would like to wish you
a happy holidays.
I'm Kyle Boone.
And I'm Shiloh. And we just wanted to say
happy holidays from us to you.
On behalf of Seaway Valley Wrestling, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year!
Mask is down quickly just to say have a Merry Christmas and thank you so much for joining us for the show. I know the holidays can bring mixed emotions. I've been there. So I do hope that, this does bring you some joy and entertainment. And also remember, you know what? There are a lot of people that aren't in your shoes right now that can watch this. So, you know what? You are blessed. And also remember, you are not alone. By all means, join us on the hashtag as when we talk about the show or anything else. By all means, we're all on Twitter. If there's anything learned from this event, focus on what's in your control. Always take care of your physical and mental health. Surround yourself with the right people to allow you to do both. And you know what? You get what you put into the world. So be well, be safe, and you know what? Just go hard at everything you do, all right? Take care. Bye.
What up, Go Hard Pro? It's the giver of vitamin D, Johnny D, and I just want to wish you the happiest of all.
Hello, everybody. I'm Classic Chris.
And I'm Alan Christopher, and we're the hosts of Border Town TV. And Classic, I'll tell you, 2020's been a real crappy year, brother.
You're right, Alan. It's time to put a leg drop on 2020 and ring in 2021. So from the Border Town Pro Wrestling family to yours, we'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays.
Cheers, everybody.
The following contest is our main event, and is a tag team match. Introducing first, from the outskirts of Whoville, the team of Gabriel Fuerza and Holden Albright!
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
Give you a Grinch.
What are you supposed to be?
Fucking dork.
So cute. It's the cutest thing I've ever seen. Oh my god, I'm gonna cry.
Don't you guys love Christmas? Don't you guys love Christmas as much as I do?
I love Christmas. Honestly, I do. I just really want to destroy it. It's not personal. I'm not the crazy one. What kind of stupid song is this? Is she singing this?
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass.
Alexia, tis I, Santa Puff, and I hear what you're saying. I hear your calls for Christmas, and how you wanna get rid of that Grinch, Fuerza, and his little dog friend. And have no fear, I'm here to help you. I'm here to answer your calls. But I gotta tell you that Christmas isn't something that's tangible, you know? It's in your heart, and it's in your spirit. And unfortunately, I can't be there physically, tangibly, to help you out with your problem, because Santa Puff can't get across the border no matter what. But I've called upon someone who embodies that spirit of Christmas. And that person is Ethan Bay.
Introducing next, her partner, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. He weighs in at 222 pounds, the spirit of Christmas, all evil, Ethan!
Oh, hey, relax, big guy.
Yeah,
for sure.
Right.
That's not her heart, bro.
Okay. Family show?
I don't know.
More. Let's do one more. You catch a catch can type girl? Let's do it.
There you go. Catch what? You're about to catch another shoulder injury. Whoa! Relax! Relax!
One! Two!
I don't know, I think she's kind of adorable, don't she?
Three!
I think she's pretty cute.
Oh, you better stop! Hey! My tag partner!
Back. Go!
There you go. Keep fighting, reach. Keep fighting.
No. Let go.
Come on, Forza. Reach.
I'm too smart for you.
Let him go.
Yes. Hey.
Let me fucking get her.
Come on, Alexia!
We gotta get out, let's go!
I'm trying!
Come on, Alexia!
Two!
Oh, damn it! Kick out! Yeah. Okay, no!
Cheat again. He already paid the ref off.
No official wears an elf costume.
Come on, who? Who better? Who better than Whoville? Huh? Okay. Yes! Oh! Watch your back. Kick out. The ref is still dead. Kick out.
Oh,
thank goodness. I'm not trying to get DQ'd. Thank goodness. Come on, Alexia. I'm looking at your ugly ass. Come on, Alexia! Come on! Okay!
Now I have to look at it.
There you go!
Careful! She's right there!
Oh! No! Don't stop!
What?
No!
Yes!
Oh, no!
Alexia!
Send help. Send help for the love of God. It's Christmas. Help me, somebody.
Good to stand outside, huh? Huh? Well, come on, then. Christmas and all evil is dead.
One, two, three. Come on.
Okay, I got a backup plan.
Let's finish him then. You ready?
Ready.
Go up top. We got this.
Yeah!
Hey guys, it's Ryan and Ariana Knight here from the Knights of the Squared Circle. We hope you guys are having as much fun as we are with tonight's show.
We just wanted to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. We hope you enjoyed the rest of the show.
And we also wanted to make sure you guys check out Knights of the Squared Circle on Facebook, Spotify, Instagram, you name it, it's everywhere. Oh, sorry, keep plugging. Anyways, guys, enjoy the show. Thanks.
We are live on the internet wishing you a Merry Christmas.
Happy Halloween.
What the f- Who are you?
God.
What? It's cold out. There's snow. It's Christmas time. Happy holidays.
We're in December, man.
Yeah. This. What do you mean?
This is for
going. I've been in my house. No. I have been in my house for so long now. I swear we're in October.
You still have your Halloween stash, don't you?
No.
Did nobody give him the script?
No.
Like, hey, well, do we? Fine, I'll just be quiet.
Yeah, shut up.
Fine. This is for Go Hard Pro. We want to say have a happy holidays, Merry Christmas from Pro Wrestling Ontario. Says it on the belt there. And have a good one.
Merry Christmas, happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
There you go, you got a happy holidays.
All right.
Jerk this unit. Positive. I've been watching this kid for weeks.
Work on the signage a little.
Show me how it's done, Sensei.
Crowbar, right? Sit.
Gonna work. I'm telling you, it's not gonna work.
On the trails. This way.
It's not gonna work, alright? We need something stronger than these crowbars. It's not just gonna open up.
We found the right tool to open it.
Guess it worked. Steve, what?
There is nobody under this. ring.
He just went back under.
Why are you handcuffed?
Because he handcuffed me.
I thought he was under the ring.
No, he got in, came out of the ring, called me an idiot, handcuffed me, and then ran back under the ring as he came. But look, over there. There's the key. See it?
There?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I see it. I'll get it.
Wait.
Steve! I'll get him!
Good with geometry?
Eureka!
I don't think that's gonna hold.
Steve, I'm hanging! I'm scared of heights!
Crimity, he's down here!
There it is! Steve, my grip's ripped! Steve!
Hey, how's it hanging?
Are you okay? Did you get the key?
I got the key.
Can you pass it to me?
Work with me, Steve.
There he goes, come on, let's get him!
Shit. That's exactly what he wants us to do.
Okay? Are you okay?
Yes.
Sonny!
Yes? That's it, I'm calling the cops.
Whoa. Listen, nothing would thrill me more than to kill you. Honestly, plugging a kindergartner is not going to make me feel bad. But why don't you take the phone, throw it down to me, stay up there, we'll get what we came for, and then we'll get out of here.
Okay.
Ow! Ow! Oh. Kurt, you okay? How many fingers am I holding up?
Hey!
What the hell's wrong with you? You better not have any more bricks up there. He doesn't have any more bricks. Oh.
Oh. Man, you guys are having a really bad Christmas.
I'm gonna murder that kid. I can't see anything.
I know all your tricks.
No, I'm sorry.
I got you, you're dead now, kid. I gotta scrap this whole place.
Ah.
Susie.
How'd that feel?
You're one angry young lady.
What we are going to do to you is going to be biblical!
Yeah. It's with the finger. What does that mean? What is that?
I'm gonna bite that finger off.
Don't bite it.
Oh man, Marley, you came to save me. Let's take it home. Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! No!
Yeah!
Yeah!
I got it.
Hello, 911. We got the damp bandits here.
Hey, Christmas.
In the weird world of 2020, the baby faces were victorious and you sent the crowd home happy. Happy holidays from us to you.
Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.